Hi, this is Quad, and in this video, I want to tell you about cell signaling of T-cell coactivation. Here is a T-cell, T-cell receptor, CD4, and here is an antigen presenting cell, professional one, with MHC2, and the antigen. Now when this TCR CD4 of the T cell binds with the MHC2 antigen complex of the antigen presenting cell, like a dendritic cell, TCR and CD4 signals CD3, which has a domain facing inside of a cell called the immunoreceptor tyrosine activating motif. And this ITAM activation signals more processes. And this TCR activating of the CD3 is a common initial step in NK cell activation and many other T cell activations. The signal activates ZAP70, resulting in the increased calcium concentration in the T cell. And this increased calcium concentration can activate the DAG, which will eventually activate NF-kappa-B. NF-kappa-B is a transcription factor, so it's going to go to the nucleus and change the gene expression of this T cell. Also, the increased calcium concentration leads to binding of calcineurin, and calcineurin activates NFAT, which stands for nuclear factor of activated T cell. And EdFAT is also a transcription factor, and it can go to the nucleus and change the gene expression. Finally, other pathways leads to RAS signaling and AP1 signaling. And this signaling pathway will also eventually target the nucleus. NF-kappa-B, EdFAT, and RAS AP1 pathways and the gene expression change results in making of CD28, CD40, IL-2 ligand, and IL-2 receptor by the T cell. Anti-inflammatory drugs like glucocorticoid inhibits calcineurin activity and RAS pathway. Cyclosporine also inhibits the calcineurin signaling. JAK inhibitors inhibits the signaling that come from the binding of co-stimulating protein IL-2 ligand and IL-2 receptor. In fact, JAK inhibitors can block many other chemokine, cytokine receptor signalings. Overall, the anti-inflammatory drugs don't inhibit the specific binding of the TCR and MHC, but inhibit the co-stimulating pathways.